Hey there, gang. Welcome back to the Missouri Liberty Alliance. Today's Friday, October 29th, 2021. Guys, it's Friday. Several reasons to celebrate today. Firstly, it's Friday, dude. You know, you got to celebrate on Friday because that's like the beginning of the weekend, right? We got other things to celebrate, though. Okay. What are we celebrating exactly? Well, an executive order. An executive order from Governor Parsons. It's amazing. I know it is because he tweeted out, he says, "We have issued Executive Order 2110 to protect the individual rights of Missourians against overreaching federal COVID-19 vaccination mandates." It's from the governor. So I can't read it real well, though. I mean, I don't know if you guys can read it. So let's go ahead and look at it over here. So let's see. Let's see. There's a lot of stuff in here. I don't know what I could do to make this easier. Well, I like this one here. Whereas, which again, these are clauses before, like a preamble to the actual, you know, executive order. Whereas more than 50% of the population of the state of Missouri has initiated the COVID-19 vaccination process, and vaccinations are available to all Missourians at no cost. Available to all Missourians at no cost. So the vaccines come at no cost. Okay, I bought it. It's very important not to critically think. It helps you keep your YouTube channel alive and well. Okay, gang, let's go down and read the meat. The meat of this burger, right? Okay, it says, "Now, therefore, I, Michael R. Parson, governor of the state of Missouri, by virtue of the authority vested in me by the Constitution and the laws of the state of Missouri, I hereby order and direct the following actions intended to oppose the Biden administration's overriding federal COVID-19." And by the way, YouTube, I'm just reading an executive order. Don't be slapping me with strikes and all that kind of stuff, please. Okay, let's get to the meat of it now. "All agencies, boards, commissions, and other entities within the executive branch of the state government are directed to cooperate fully and timely with the Attorney General of the State of Missouri in furtherance of any litigation filed by the Attorney General on behalf of the State of Missouri against any federally imposed COVID-19 vaccine mandate or requirement." That almost sounds deliberately ambiguous. Okay, let's read part two. This is probably, it's in the middle, so I'm sure that that's the meat of the sandwich. Let's get there. "No agency, board, commission, or any other entity within the executive branch of the state government shall comply any individual to receive the COVID-19 vaccine pursuant to federal vaccine mandate, whereas such individual objects by reason of sincerely held religious belief or for medical reasons." Okay, once again, we have that disturbing, reoccurring phrase here, executive branch of the state government. Okay, this could be one of those unusual sandwiches where there's two pieces of bread with the meat on the very bottom. So let's read the third one. "No agency, board, commission, or other entity within the executive branch of the state government shall, under color of state law, impose a penalty on any individual or business for noncompliance with any federally imposed COVID-19 vaccine mandate or requirement, whereas noncompliance is a result of the individual's sincerely held religious belief for medical reasons." That can't be right. Because apart from this being very ambiguous, difficult to understand, it doesn't look like it actually helps anyone in Missouri except for state employees and contractors. Once again, under the executive branch of the state government. Under the executive branch of the state government. "No agency, board, commission, or any other entity within the executive branch of state government." Well, he put on his tweet here, "We've issued an executive order 2110 to protect the individual rights of Missourians against overreaching federal COVID-19 vaccine mandates." The individual rights of Missourians. Executive branch. I get it. You tried to pull a fast one on me, didn't you, Governor Parson? You almost had me. I was pretty excited. I had, literally celebrate by cooling the gang, ready to go and everything. You almost made me forget that incident that happened 2 weeks ago, Governor Parson, where you threatened a reporter who actually found a coding flaw in the Missouri Department of Elementary and Secondary Education's website that exposed all the Social Security numbers of all the teachers in the state. Remember when you threatened that reporter with prosecution because you said he was a hacker? You almost had me forget that, Governor Parson. You're a pretty sneaky guy. Okay, guys, that's all I have for today. You all have a wonderful day. Don't forget, Sunday night at 7:30, we're going live. So put that on your calendar. Those of you on our email list will get a heads up. You guys have a wonderful day. May God bless each and every one of you. Take care, gang.